Watching him train, you'd never know Lieutenant Brad Snyder is blind. He's just weeks away from the Paralympics in London, and it's not at all where he thought he'd be going this time last year. Lieutenant Snyder was a Navy bomb diffuser serving in Afghanistan when an IED exploded. It cost the 28-year-old both of his eyes.
Thankfully, the detonation occurred a few feet in front of me, largely saving the majority of my body.
Despite his injuries, Lieutenant Snyder made a quick recovery. He recently moved to Baltimore for an internship with a software company that supports veterans. And he's teamed up with Loyola University swim coach Brian Leffler. He's been coaching para-athletes since 2007.
At our trials that we had in Bismarck back in June, he swam 7 events, and in 2 of them, he's currently ranked number 1 in the world.
And in London, Lieutenant Snyder will compete for Team USA in over half a dozen events.
Being able to throw a flag on my shoulder in a different way, not necessarily in a military uniform, but in Team USA's uniform, it goes a long way in making me feel relevant again.
Lieutenant Snyder is going to swim his most competitive event, the 400-meter freestyle, on September 7th. That date's pretty significant because it's the one-year anniversary of the explosion that took his eyes.
Regardless of the outcome, it's just going to be awesome to compete on that day. And in my mind, it really goes a long way to say that I've effectively conquered my disability.
His determination and positive attitude made an impression on First Lady Michelle Obama, who used Lieutenant Snyder's story to motivate graduates at Oregon State University.
Of his service, he said this. He said, "I am not going to let my blindness build a brick wall around me. I'd give my eyes 100 times again to have the chance to do what I have done and what I can still do."
And Leffler, who will coach Team USA in London, says Snyder is truly a hero.
Yeah, him being a veteran and him serving for his country and having his accident happen in that situation is inspirational to many.
Jennifer Franciotti, WBAL-TV 11 News.